for? Not bad, don't want to push that. Oh, me. Ripping my shoulders apart.
3, 2, 1, go.
One more.
And time. Great effort.
I'd say so myself. That was a pretty big session. I definitely could have done a lot more, but the box squats felt great. Did doubles all the way across the board, added an extra band. Measuring the bands, I didn't get, the only band I could measure at the top were the red bands, which are equivalent to lights, and they gave me roughly 75 pounds at the top. The others, I have no idea. My scale won't measure them at the top. So they are what they, either way, it's band tension. It's not real weight, it's band tension. I am a speed lifter, I'm a fast lifter. I thrive from quick movements, so the chances are the more that you weigh me down with bands and give me the option to use my speed, the better off I'm gonna be. So one would think that I would stay away from bands because I'm good at them, but the one thing that I've lost over the last few years as I've gotten older is my ability to be dynamic, my ability to use my athleticism. I was never the brute force guy. I was never the biggest guy in the sport. But I was athletic. I could move, I could run, I could jump, and I could beat people a little bit on athleticism, and then I could throw in a little bit of, I don't want to say toughness, maybe stupidity in there as well. So I need to get the athleticism back. I need to get that back. And I need to slowly get to the point to where I can grind with those bands and maybe shift to chains. But getting doubles where I got singles on everything last week, four plates, added an extra band, weighed them at the bottom. The weights at the bottom were roughly 90 pounds for the Mondos, 80 pounds for the heavies, somewhere around there. And 35 pounds or so for the lights at the bottom. So that's what you know is on the bar at the bottom when I'm at a stop position, plus the weight. I could have gone heavier, but the more I thought about it, the more I didn't need to take it. It was killing my hands. It was eating into my wrist, my biceps, and that weight going across my back, I'm just not used to it. Better than last week, but not used to it. The good mornings were absolutely great. I don't know what else I could ask for with the good mornings. I just need to make slow progress with those. I need to add a set next week of the bar and the bands. I need to add a set next week of the bar and a plate, and then slowly start working my way up to where I can use a bar of bands and two plates for three sets of six. Probably don't need to be explosive. Need to be similar to what you saw today. Consistent. I'm not for sure if I'm going to be ready to be explosive or if I need to be explosive, which goes against everything I've ever preached on those good mornings. So if you're one of my clients and you're used to me telling you to be explosive out of the hole on the good mornings, this is where I'm at. And if you're at where I'm at, then remind me and we'll change you as well. So I decided not to do any kind of deadlifts. I thought about doing the sumo box deadlifts, some time sets, just some pickups and holds. But I thought my back might appreciate another week of rest as long as I could hit all the other body parts with everything else. Went back in the back. 10 seconds work, 10 seconds rest, 6 rounds. If you're one of my clients, you've done this a lot with triple 8s, triple 10s, triple 12s, maybe even triple 15s. Depending, you know, a lot of triceps will do triple 12s, lats, triple 12s, and triple 15s. I started out with 6s. I want my hamstrings. You'll watch. I missed with the right leg, with the weak leg, with the nerve damage. I'm struggling hitting failure repeatedly. So, and I think it's probably a good thing that my body's not finding a workaround to make the lift, to make the ham curl, because that would mean my body is going to learn wrong patterns as a makeshift leg curl. You know, and I don't want it to. I want it to stick with the right pattern and not be able to function. And as I slowly gain the function, as I slowly gain the strength, I hope it will start to fire in the right pattern. So that's my thought process on that. The leg extensions, I wanted to go heavier. My left knee was hurting. I have no idea. Left knee has a hurt. My right knee's been bothering me for, you know, a week or two, just going up and down stairs. Have no idea, but it's just one of those things. Got the leg extensions in. Did some abs, came in here, did some, gosh, calf raises, which I hate, and then finished off with the Thompsons and the floor. Those things are just now starting to light me up everywhere. So going home, definitely going to eat, watch, my son said he wanted to watch Mandalorian tonight because we're behind on an episode, and my whole family's sick, except for me. Knock on wood. Man, we don't have wood in this place anymore. There's a piece of wood somewhere. Wood, plastic woods, anything. Got to work tonight, and I'll do some Thompsons and abs again before bed. Probably the same thing that you saw me do here today. I've got to fry my glutes, fry my low back, keep my hamstrings fried and working. I can do some quads as well. Rest tomorrow, which means abs and Thompsons for recovery. Get back in here and bench press on Friday. So that's it, guys. We'll see you on Friday.